Joining us now, former Senator and former Majority and Minority Leader Tom Daschle from South Dakota. Senator, welcome to the program. Thanks for joining
us. Thanks, guys. Good to be here.
Let me just start off with what I think is an obvious question. It's a day of great frustration for us, and I hope for you as well. The detainee torture bill includes giving the president a broad discretion to authorize torture, no habeas corpus, limitless detention without seeing a judge, items which are in direct contradiction to the Constitution and 230 years of American law. If the Democrats weren't willing to filibuster this bill, then what would they possibly be willing to filibuster?
Well, it's a sad day. We've lost our soul. We've lost our moral authority. As I travel abroad, it's just amazing. You know, in the battle for the hearts and minds of people all over the world, we're not winning today, and these are reasons why. I mean, as you say, 200 years of constitutional principles go out the window, and it's very, very troubling. Franklin Roosevelt said the only thing we have to fear is fear itself, and we're plenty fearful these days, and it's driven out of fear, and in many, many ways, I think it's a real corrosion to the whole concept of freedom as we've known it for two centuries.
Well, Senator Daschle, unfortunately, it appears that some of the Democratic senators are also afraid, that the fear that you're talking about there. And, you know, obviously you served as their leader for a long time in the Senate. And why is it so hard to organize Democrats to vote to do the right thing? I mean, why could we only get 32 Democratic senators to vote against this bill, let alone filibustering?
Well, I wasn't there, and it's hard for me to make any comment about what may or may not happen in the caucus or on the floor. All I know is that obviously this has been a very divisive issue in our caucus, in our party, in our country. There is a lot of question as to where the balance ought to be, and I obviously will give the benefit of the doubt to those who differ with me, but I just think that this is a time when we need to stand up on such important principles. We've gone through this in our past. We did it in World War II, and we imprisoned Japanese, and, you know, we made mistakes along the way. We did it with the Dred Scott decision, and I think we're doing it again now. I think it's very unfortunate.
Senator Daschle, I have to ask, I don't know if you can answer, but they must want, you know, they obviously support this position, so I don't know why they don't come out publicly with it. Who are the, let me put it this way, the cautious Democratic senators? The ones that say, whoa, wait a minute, this maybe might not make political sense to vote against this bill. You've been in that caucus. You were their leader. Can you tell us who are the more cautious Democratic senators?
Oh, I think that's probably pretty evident with the votes that have been cast over the last few months. And I don't know if I want to get into naming names. I think that it's so important for us, even those who may feel that way, to draw some distinctions. This administration is out of control. It is incompetent, it is arrogant, and it is increasingly dangerous, I think, in so many of its respects, to the kinds of things that we fought for and died for 200 years. We're giving up our freedom to a certain extent today, and I think that's a tragedy.
We're talking to a former Senate Majority and Minority Leader, Tom Daschle. Senator, let me ask you a political question then. The vote that on Arlen Specter's amendment to restore habeas corpus, take that removal of habeas corpus out of the bill, was defeated 51-48, indicating that the full Democratic caucus, just about the full caucus, was in support of that. Does it work? So what happens? Why then were there not 45 Democrats or 44 at the very least voting against the bill? In general, like when you were there, do you release senators once it's apparent that you're going to lose to vote to protect themselves? I think foolishly protect themselves, but to protect themselves for the upcoming elections that they specifically have in 6 weeks.
Well, I guess I would say even Arlen Specter. You know, Specter was the author of that amendment.
Yeah.
He made a passionate case for it from what I could read in the papers this morning, and then turned around and voted for the bill. So even though he lost this critical amendment, so it's really happening on both sides of the aisle. Senator Specter's rationalization for it was that there were some good things in the bill that he was voting for, and he thought the courts would correct the habeas corpus issue. I hope he's right, but I guess that's probably why some people voted the way they did. That is that they felt that there was some good in the bill that they wanted to vote for, and they'd work on the bad stuff later.
Senator Daschle, you're undoubtedly right about that, by the way. Arlen Specter said it turned back the clock 900 years, and then he voted yes, which is unbelievable. But there's some chance that some of the Democrats have unfortunately taken the wrong lesson from your earlier defeat. What do you think was a correct lesson to learn there? What would you have done differently, and what would you give as advice to the Democrats in 2006?
Well, I'm probably the last guy you should ask that question. I don't think I'd do anything differently. I'm very proud of what I did and how I did it, and I have no regrets. I mean, you know, if your position to get to the Senate is to stay in the Senate, you're never going to cast a tough vote. You're always going to run away from the tough fights, and you're not going to be a very good senator. I think you've got to stand up, say what you believe, vote your conscience, do the right thing, and defend those votes the next election, and expect that, you know, in politics you're going to win or you're going to lose. I didn't lose because of my votes. There may have been other things, but I don't think it was that.
Well, Senator Daschle, I mean, it's certainly good to hear that. It certainly appears that Democrats are often afraid of the ads that Republicans will run if they vote the wrong way on issues like this. But by the way, we agree with you. Don't get us wrong. We're frustrated with the Democrats. We know who the real bad guy, the much worse guys here is the administration who orchestrated this and the Republican-led Senate that pushed it through.
Well, it's good talking to both of you, and let me know when you want to do it again.
Oh, right. We'd love to have you on any time, Senator. Sure. Thanks very much. Have a great weekend. Former Senator Tom Daschle joining us here on the Young Turks.
Possibly running in 08, but we didn't Tim Russert him and ask him that question. All right. Guys, have a great weekend. We'll see you next week on the Young Turks on Air America Radio.